congratulations to today's daily shoutout winners. If you want to win a shoutout, leave a nice comment down below for a chance to win a shoutout in my next video.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, hi, my name is Lucy. Be sure to hit the subscribe button if you guys are new to the channel, because we are so close to hitting 2 million subscribers, and I have a huge surprise once we get to 2 million subscribers, and I don't want you guys to miss out on that. Also guys, be sure to drop a like on today's video, and if this video gets to 20,000 likes, I will dress up Angel as a little alien in the next video. Sadly, on our last video, we didn't get to 20,000 likes, so I didn't get to dress her up as a bunny. No! Oh, you guys missed out on seeing cute Angel Bunny. So get this video to 20,000 likes. Anyways, guys, today I am so excited because we're going to be talking about one of my favorite things, which is theme parks. I don't know about you guys, but I've always loved theme parks. I love roller coasters. I love thrill rides. I love theme park history. I love going to literally every theme park that I can and just eating all the food and playing all the games. I've just always loved theme parks ever since I was a little girl. I remember my first theme park or like roller coaster that I went on in a theme park was at Valley Fair in Minnesota, and I was so scared of this really big coaster called the Wild Thing, and I remember I was scared to get on the roller coaster, but then once I did, I always just loved roller coasters, theme parks. I couldn't get enough of them, and I also loved the Mall of America growing up, and now of course my favorite theme park is Disneyland because that's the best theme park ever. But today we're going to be talking about scary, abandoned, haunted theme parks that shut down forever. There is so many crazy theme parks that were once open that had tons of people every single day, just like Disneyland and all the other popular theme parks, got shut down or went bankrupt or somehow closed down and now sit all alone, abandoned with all the rides together, and have some really creepy backstories. So today we're going to be talking about some theme parks that you should never go to at night that are abandoned. Let's get started. So the first scary, abandoned, haunted theme park we're going to be talking about today is Daddy Park. The name already bothers me, but let me tell you guys about this place. This Belgian theme park began as a refuge for bored church children and was closed down when a boy lost his arm in the theme park. As a church playground for the children, Daddy Park became Belgium's first private amusement park. It was originally built in 1950 as a playground for children of pilgrims visiting the nearby Basquella, but by 1980, the schoolyard equipment had been replaced with amusement rides and open to tourists and those in town on pilgrimage. For a time, the park enjoyed great success, entertaining a million visitors during its peaks of the year. However, this theme park started to have some bad luck, and things got a little bit too hazardous for the guests. Finally, in 2000, a boy lost his arm on one of the jet rides, and by 2002, the site was closed down for renovation. Unfortunately, these improvements never took place, and the park was simply abandoned, never to ever reopen again. Today, the park lies in shambles, slated for demolition since 2011. Most of the larger rides were demolished, but many of the buildings and simpler attractions still remain. Where Daddy Park was built to cater to local Catholic children and religious tourists, the rusting site only ended up catering to pilgrims as urban explorers. That is honestly pretty creepy, and that's crazy that a kid lost his arm on one of the rides. First off, that's really sad, but second off, that's really creepy. I don't even know how that could happen on a ride, but it was one of the oldest theme parks ever built, so that's creepy. Next theme park. The next theme park we're going to be talking about actually is located in Japan, and it's called Dreamland. Dreamland Japan was actually pretty inspired by Disneyland. It was open for 45 years from 1961 and closed permanently in 2006. It ended up closing due to falling attendance and not being able to compete against its competitors like Disneyland and other theme parks. Matsuo, a Japanese businessman and president of the Matsu Entertainment Company, actually visited Disneyland, which inspired him to open Nara Dreamland. On July 1st of 1961, Nara Dreamland was opened to the public, and the entrance of the park was designed to look almost identical to Disneyland, including its own versions of the Train Depot, Main Street USA, and the familiar Sleeping Beauty Castle at the very entrance of Disneyland. It also had a Matterhorn-type mountain and a skyway running through it, as well as this park also had its own mascots, Ran-Chan and Joy-Chan, two children dressed as bearskin guard. This park was originally really popular as it was the only thing kind of close to Disneyland in Japan. At its peak, the park had 1.7 million visitors a year. However, Nara city government gained ownership of the park after the park's owner fell behind in property taxes. In 2013, the city put up a site for auction, but the auction received no bids. Eventually, this park actually could not afford to keep operating due to all the competition and upcoming theme parks and other parks in Japan or in the world that were getting more attention than Nara Dreamland, even though at one point it was incredibly popular. Now it sits alone, completely abandoned, abandoned, and many people will never get to see it. They do still have some pieces and parts laying around. Rumor has it that some people have seen the abandoned park sitting there, but it's pretty empty. Next park. So the next theme park we're going to be talking about is actually a theme park that some of you guys might have actually visited. So it was Six Flags, and it was not just any Six Flags, but it was the Six Flags in New Orleans. Six Flags New Orleans is a 146.2-acre abandoned theme park in New Orleans. It first opened in 2000, but has been completely closed since it was seriously damaged during the flooding of Hurricane Katrina. Hurricane Katrina actually hit that entire area, and since that hurricane, a lot of things have still not been repaired or built back up, including the Six Flags theme park. Despite various proposals to redevelop the site, it ended up remaining abandoned, overgrown with plants, infested with wildlife, and in poor, terrible condition. Despite these deteriorants, videos and photos of the site have surfaced over the years from thrill seekers and YouTube users. As a result, city officials became more diligent in securing the park and banning tours. The city has assigned police officers from the New Orleans Police Department to patrol the abandoned site and arrest offenders. So even though it was open, and maybe some of you guys have even been to the theme park, ever since Hurricane Katrina actually hit, this place has been completely just wrecked and destroyed and shut down, which is pretty sad because Six Flags can be pretty big theme park. Next theme park. So this next theme park is actually really, really creepy. It has a quite dark story to it. This abandoned theme park is in West Virginia. It's called the Old Lake Shawnee Amusement Park. It has been decades since Lake Shawnee Amusement Park buzzed with laughter and children. But according to the local legend, this park is still a playground for many ghosts. The Southern West Virginia Park was abandoned in 1966 after the accidental death of its young patrons. But it seems like Lake Shawnee's haunted history reaches much, much further back. And that's because this theme park was actually built over top of Indian burial grounds. Mercer County was home to a Native American tribe until 1983, when a European's family attempted to settle the land sparked a violent turf war. The patron of the family was a farmer named Michelle Clay. While he was out hunting, a band of Native Americans reportedly killed his youngest son, Barchley Clay. A daughter, Tabitha, was knifed to death in the struggle. Eldest son was kidnapped and burned at the stake on this land. Centuries later, in 1920s, a businessman named Conley T. Schneidel purchased the site of the Clay farm and developed it into an amusement park. He built a swing set, a Ferris wheel, and opened up a pond for swimming. However, little did they know that death still portrayed over that land, and that land was cursed and extremely haunted. A little girl in a pink ruffled dress met her end after climbing into the circling swing set. She was killed after a truck backed into the path of the swing. Another little one, and this time a boy drowned in the amusement park's swimming pond. This park's rides were responsible of a total of 6 deaths. This park eventually shut down, but the structures were left to rot and rust. This park's new owner, Gaylord White, says that he can hear the wooden swings creak, though it may not be the wind that pushes them. Sometimes the seat will start to move underneath your hand and you will feel cold air blowing through the seat. And when you get into the middle, you feel something warm, and we believe it's the spirit of one of the kids that might have died in the park. One of the current owners of the land says that they actually think they've seen the ghost on the property. "She looked at me, and as long as she looked at me, I couldn't even move." He claimed he saw the little girl in her dress covered in blood on this haunted property. Paranormal investigators now frequent the site. It has also been featured on the Discovery Channel's Ghost Lab and the Travel Channel's The Most Terrifying Places in America. That story is so creepy. Those are some of the most terrifying, scariest abandoned theme parks that I've ever heard of, or just the most unique and historical ones that I've seen. Let me know in the comments down below, would you guys visit a haunted abandoned theme park? I would be really curious, but kind of scared. It is crazy how dangerous theme parks can be, especially if a ride were to break. And if you think about it, every ride eventually does break, which is kind of creepy. Anyways, guys, that's going to do it for today's video about haunted, scary theme parks that you guys should never visit. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to drop a like and hit that subscribe button. It's been Lissy. Thank you all so much for watching today's video, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys!
So that was it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you guys enjoyed, be sure to hit the subscribe button, be sure to drop a like, and be sure to leave a comment down below. I will see you guys next time. Goodbye.